So, Succession. Season 3 is officially over, the thing I've waited months for, the thing some people have waited years for, and I gotta talk about it. We're gonna start with some spoiler-free talk, because maybe some of you haven't finished the season, or some of you haven't even started the show. I don't know why you would watch this if that were the case, but anyway. I thought this was a great season. A very different season than the last two, but quite possibly the show at its best. It actually built out characters that really needed to go somewhere. It challenged a lot of characters who felt unstoppable. The chaos was through the roof pretty consistently. And more than anything, I think this season solidified it as being probably the best acted show on television. I know there's a lot of weird discourse surrounding that Jeremy Strong profile. I personally thought that it was just a really well-researched piece that went into how serious he takes his craft, not a hit piece by any means. And him, Kieran Culkin, Sarah Snook, and frickin' Matthew McFadyen, everyone is dishing out deliciously weird performances. The newbies were all really good too. I demand more Adrian Brody in the next season. Alexander Skarsgård is already a classic. What a character. It is easily the best thing on TV right now. I'm deeply upset that I have to wait so long for season 4, but that does it for spoiler-free talk. Don't head out yet, because before we get into it, I want to thank Sony for sponsoring this video. It's funny, you know, ever since Sony sent me their Sony Bravia XR-A80J 4K HDR OLED TV, things have been going really well for me. It comes with Cognitive Processor XR, revolutionary TV processing that understands how humans see and hear to deliver realistic picture quality. It's like I'm hanging out with Peter Rabbit. With the XR Triluminous Pro, I'm able to see billions of accurate colors and impressive picture quality that is natural and beautiful to the human eye. The other day I was tying my shoe and I got so immersed in what I was watching. Well, anyway. I like my pixels how I like my coffee, black. And with XR OLED contrast, I get premium OLED picture quality with true black and vibrant color. And searching has been made easy. All I gotta do is press the Google Assistant button on my remote and say, play an action movie, to search across my favorite apps. And just like that, I'm at the edge of my seat. And with the Bravia Core app available exclusively on Bravia XR TVs, I can bring the cinematic experience home by watching new and exciting films like Venom, Let There Be Carnage. This combination of sound and picture quality has allowed me to rediscover the magic of some of my favorite movies from the comfort of my living room. Check out the Sony Bravia XR-A80J 4K HDR OLED TV. So, how about that finale, right? It's funny, season 1 ended with a historic L for Kendall, season 2 ended with an even more historic W. This... I can't even tell at this point. I think it's been a really interesting season to analyze because season 1 was clearly all about Kendall, season 2 was for Shiv, and this season was Roman's, but it was also most certainly Tom's. Tom had a phenomenal season, and if anything, took home one of the biggest wins by the end. This entire season, from episode 1, has been making the case that Logan always wins. That's just how it is. Nobody likes that, but he's the man. He knows the business, he doesn't bullshit around, and he actually gets stuff done and makes the calls. His competence is proven in episode 5 at the shareholder meeting when Logan has a crazy awful medical emergency and things are left up to the kids. Arguably one of the best episodes in this entire season. I don't think my butt cheeks have clenched this hard the entire show. And without the dad, these kids cannot make a decision if they had a gun to their head, which is pretty much what's happening here. Tom may not be any more competent, to be honest, citing back to the courtroom scenes and also pretty much every other scene in the show, but he's in such a good spot being there for Logan, earning Logan's trust, and being a better person than any of the kids. At one point, he calls him dad, Logan calls him son. He's certainly in a better position than Shiv, and he's not even in the family. But maybe that's why he's in such a good position, but we're getting too ahead of ourselves. Shiv is in a really hilarious spot. Shiv is so determined to come out on top and to stick to the route she's in, despite getting shit on at every single turn. The only place she really felt like she has a true sense of authority is in her sad excuse of a marriage with Tom, and a good portion of this season is Tom kind of putting his foot down and rising above that. And I'll be the first to say it, I'm happy for Tom. The man has been in an abusive relationship for too long, and to see a fellow from St. Paul, Minnesota come out on top by the end is just, it makes you smile. I think everything that happens to Tom this season really proves how great the show is at creating dramatic tension. You see this man sink to the lowest of lows and talk about prison for basically half the season to a point where you're like, damn, he really is gonna go to prison, isn't he? And then, like this show does, they completely completely dismiss any of that happening in like 30 seconds at the beginning of the birthday episode, where they're like, yeah, actually, he's probably not gonna go to prison. But then Logan's like, I'll remember, referring back to when Tom was like, I'll go to prison for you, Logan. And you get such a mixed feeling of relief and also never-ending dread. That's how I read that, at least. A lot of people look at that as a really good moment for Tom, like he solidified Logan's trust without having to pay the consequences. But now I also see Logan looking at Tom as someone he can throw under at any moment now that he knows Tom is willing. Like, sure, Tom's strat of getting close to Logan makes him a trustworthy asset, but at the same time, Logan kind of looks at Tom in the same way he looked at Roman, as just like a guy who's willing to do whatever for daddy and is willing to go under the bus at any moment. You're close to the dad, but at what cost? What I'm saying though is that Tom is without a doubt the protagonist this season, regardless of everything I just said. The outsider and insider of the family, the only one that really had to work to get to where he's at. Sure, he can be a bit of a goof, but he's literally been behind the scenes this whole season, getting Shiv to open up about anything and everything without her realizing that he's within arm's reach of Logan. Like, what the hell? And he has Greg. Let's talk about Greg. I won't lie to you, I expected more from Greg this season, which isn't to say it was a disappointment or that he isn't in a good spot. I just think Greg is in the same good spot that he was in before. He went from Kendall's side, where it's like kind of risky but moving up, and somehow slowly maneuvered his way over to Tom, which is kind of the same thing. But once again, he's in this place where we can all be like, ooh, next season, it's gonna be Greg. But that's what we all said last time too, him being right next to Kendall and all. But I will say, things do look a lot more interesting for Greg. Maybe he'll end up in Luxembourg royalty, apparently. And I'll say that the homoerotic tension between him and Tom this season was insane. Oh my God. I love that the show seems to actually be doing something with that and moving closer and closer towards an actual relationship. I genuinely think they're gonna kiss at some point. It has to happen. If it doesn't, truly, what is the point of all of this? Now, as for Connor, I got pretty much exactly what I wanted out of Con this season, and his final little argument with the other siblings really put him in an interesting spot for next season. Months leading up to this new season, I was really pushing for Connor to be an actual person and for them to write him as, you know, a character. Connor is, at the end of the day, the eldest son, but it's been proven time and time again that he's just not capable of taking that top spot. And to be clear, I'm talking about both of the top spots he's going for. I mean, there's that moment in the episode where they're picking the president where you're like, oh my God, Connor is actually maybe gonna be the president, but then he blows it almost immediately and you're like, oh right, it's just Connor. The best thing going for him right now is Willa saying fuck it to his marriage proposal, which happened at a wedding. Insane. But again, there's a lot of frustration actually happening in his character. The show is finally noticing his lack of participation, and come season 4, I think he's gonna do some questionable things to get more involved. Knowing Connor, who knows what he's gonna do? He's probably the most unpredictable character on the show, and that's why I love him so much. But you heard it here first, he's gonna do something. Now let's talk Roman, because how have we not yet? Like I said, even though this is kind of Tom's season, it's also very much Roman's. Roman had probably his best season in my opinion, maybe not as far as success goes, but this was without a doubt the most nuanced look at Roman we've seen. The dick pic scene is probably one of the best scenes in the entire show. The acting, the editing, the cinematography, the reactions, it's probably the funniest way the Jerry Roman romance thing could have ended. Yes, I'm convinced it's not happening anymore. A lot of that quote-unquote fling, if we want to call it that, thrived off the will they, won't they aspect, and if they were really going to go for it, it would complicate so many things and get really not exciting really fast. And the only thing about this that really worries me is that Jerry ends up getting fired, which seemed like a possibility for a brief second there, but moving forward, especially after that almost robotic act in the finale, it doesn't seem like she's going to be going anywhere anytime soon. The smartest people in the show are those that aren't the Roy siblings, and Jerry is one of the best examples of this. Roman had more opportunities than anyone this season to abandon or stand up to Logan. In my opinion, one of the most heartbreaking and smallest examples of this was near the beginning, where he had to come up with a memory with his father that he really cherished, and the best he could do was a fishing trip that apparently happened with Connor. Which is why I think when he sees Kendall actually hurting in the end, and also the fact that Kendall is the only one who can properly navigate the emergency happening, he kind of crosses over to the other side. Because Kendall has something that Logan doesn't, and it's actual love for his siblings. When you see them together, thinking back to that moment where they smoke on the boat, they feel like they love each other. And it all builds into Roman standing up to Logan for maybe the first time in the entire show, only to get screamed at in the end. And that makes you feel like, wow, Roman ends this season on the floor with Ken on his shoulders, a really beautiful image when paired with the vice versa that happened 20 minutes earlier. He's destroyed and feels awful, but in my opinion, he's changed as a person. He's on the cusp of an awakening and of, I don't know, actually becoming a human being, which, if I'm being honest, is what this guy finally deserves. I think Kendall put it so simply and so beautifully in the birthday episode when he says, "You're not a real person," because he's not. And maybe moving forward, he will be. And on that note, let's talk Kendall, the number one boy. This man, he's had one hell of a season. Probably the most uncomfortable character to watch by far. Those early episodes, despite sort of riding that high of the season 2 finale, he's so clearly falling without a parachute. Even in episode 1, fresh off the press conference, he appears panicked and frazzled. It was a big move, a good move too, but it's clear Ken doesn't know how to act quickly and with control the same way Logan can. Being in that top spot means being a killer, yes, but it feels like literally every sibling forgets that it needs to be handled carefully and with control in a deceptive way, not always in a straightforward way, which is why Tom is so freaking perfect for the job. He plays it so quietly. This is something Kendall hasn't and arguably still does not understand. Seeing as though his addictive personality just gets roped right back in the end of this episode, he has the siblings, he has the unit, but what use is that without a plan that sees into the future? The man wants out, and I think that's been very clear since episode 3 as everything started falling apart at the TV taping. And that's the thing. Maybe this is a hot take, but I do see Kendall coming through in the end of all of this, as in the end of the entire show. Kendall has given up on the CEO thing. I don't think it's an option, and I don't think he'd even want it at this point. What he wants is his dad out of power and for himself to get out. And not being alone in that fight anymore is extremely promising, especially when the other two people with him are Shiv and Roman. Because sure, Logan backfired in the end, but at the end of the day, Logan, just like every other character in this show, kind of thrives off the power that he has over them. All I'm saying is, I don't think it looks as bad as it is in actuality. I think they're gonna bounce back pretty hard in season 4. I'm just really excited to see what they do with it. Although I will say, Roman and Shiv knowing that he killed a kid, that's not good. That's really not gonna end well. I know this was mostly a recap for the finale, but I feel like Succession's one of those shows where the entire season builds into those last 10 minutes, and this is a great example of that. And I think in summation, obviously, I loved the hell out of this season. I think it keeps you guessing more than season 2, comes with a more in-depth look at the characters than season 1, and it sets up the next season in a truly unpredictable way. It finally feels like we're seeing a new side to all these characters, which feels exciting after, you know, feeling kind of redundant after a while. Because as a lot of critics of the show have mentioned, the show has been moving in a questionable direction of Kendall going for it and losing and then going for it again and losing even harder, and it really started to feel, like I said, kind of redundant. But this finale and the arcs that every character went through, yes, including Connor, truly make the next season a lot less about Waystar and more about Roy Co. I don't know, does that work? Because if there's one thing I learned this season, it's that Logan is a lot smarter than we all realized. He's pretty much impossible to take down, and he's an absolute beast. And while the siblings may be down now, something tells me, you know, they'll find a new angle. My favorite episode was Too Much Birthday. Lorraine Scafaria really killed it with that. My favorite scene was the Nero and Sporus confession. My favorite performance this season was probably Jeremy Strong, obviously, but I want to see Matthew McFadyen get an Emmy. My favorite line was, "Hey dude, hope you're good, just checking in, any update on the burning." My favorite new character is Lucas Mattson, and the line that made me want to scream the most was, "Who said I never killed anybody?" I don't pay too much attention to ratings for shows, but this gets a fat 5 out of 5 for me. I don't know what else I could have asked for other than more Greg, but this is simply my favorite show, and I enjoyed watching it a lot. Also, this is my Shiv costume. Thank you so much for watching. Go watch Succession and form your own opinion, and I'll see you all in the next one.